pap. I've just bought a motor car, would you care to look? At least 2,000 pages in its registration book. Its pedigree lies buried underneath its family tree. When in reverse it goes right back to 55 BC. Julius Caesar took it from the quartermaster stores. It came, it saw, it conked out when it reached old England shores. When Boadicea captured it, no other Roman road. To make the chassis match her own, she painted it with woad. We haven't a leg to stand on, came the agonizing squeals of pedestrians who'd been cut down by the size upon its wheels. It next passed to a Saxon, who affixed to it a klaxon, and this loud-speaking gadget kept all hurry word awake. Said Alfred the lawmaker, well, I am a rotten baker. This radiator's far too hot, it made me burn the cake. But this gave him an idea, so he promptly burned three more, and fitted them as disc wheels which had not been seen before. A nut canute sat in it, when the tide he tried to veto. The wave soon reached his flimsel line and shorted his magneto. And after curfew, Norman Bill once set the car afire, and said things not in doomsday book which shocked the holy friar. Richard Coeur de Lion couldn't get the thing to start, and turned the starting handle till he strained his lion heart. He bequeathed it to his brother John, who thought it wasn't posh, so sent it to the laundry, where it vanished in the wash. There it stayed 3 centuries, till Henry number 8 fished it up with Morton's fork for purposes of state. He tried to park his wives in it, alas, was rather narrow, so fitted 6 occasional seats, thus making the first sharer. Of this good Queen Bess disapproved, suggesting to Walt Raleigh another reformation, viz. 2-seater, much more pally. 'Twas garage neath Westminster, but for no apparent reason. Backfired and woke up Parliament, Guy Fawkes was hanged for treason. Charles I could not get ship money, so bought this car instead. In a traffic jam in Whitehall, the poor man lost his head. Its next owner was old Cromwell, who founded the Girl Guides. Take away that bauble he roared, fit it with iron sides. The merry monarch Charles the Tooth then made the old car rip, and to Nell Gwynn the orange girl tootled a loud pip-pip. The second James then fled in it, but it stranded him, of course, whereon Jim cried, as Richard did, my kingdom for a horse. Its exhaust blew up 40 ships, a famous Trafalgar. Said Nelson, kiss me harder, you can have the blinking car. In 14 it popped up at Mons, the Kaiser shouted bar. What a contemptible army, and what a rotten car. It's a car that's fit for heroes, said Lloyd George, it's plain to see. Only a hero dare drive it, so they gave the wreck to me. And now I'd like to sell it, though without it I'll feel strange. Did you offer me to Bob, sir?
Right.
Here's one, and now...